satellite, taking into consideration of their in-safety. And the interception has taken place at an altitude of 283 kilometers. When you look at the very critical technologies what have gone into it, the very important one, what I put it first, is the guidance and control algorithms what the scientists have designed for a precision hit. As I said right in the beginning, it's a direct hit into the satellite. So the guidance and control algorithms which have been innovative, which have been completely designed and completely simulated in various modes, have been utilized here. The strap down IAR seeker, which actually seeks and tracks the target in the terminal phase, one of the critical technologies which has been deployed. The divert and attitude control system, which requires very fast response, is another one which has been deployed, which actually has got a very fast response solenoid valves which have been designed specifically for this to respond to the scenario of very high speed scenario in the terminal phase. And of course, the ring laser gyro based navigation system is another critical technology which has been deployed. These are some of the critical technologies which I'm highlighting here, which have been deployed in this Mission Shakti. The industry has participated in this mission in a big way. More than, I think, 50 industries have participated in this. They responded to the challenge, designed and developed many of the systems, some of the major systems like launchers, nozzles, rocket motor casings, and whatnot. And I can say more than about 2,000 components, subsystems, and systems have come from industry for this mission from various industries located across the industry, across the country. The quality standards have been maintained in the industry and in the laboratories. Multiple quality teams have been deployed, and they have ensured the quality of all the systems, including the integration mechanisms, have been thorough and monitored the each and every operation with a very specific view of maintaining the utmost quality. The quality teams in the industry, in the laboratories, and the quality assurance agencies all have participated in this mission, ensuring a success. The mission planning specifically, even though the interceptor has the capability to intercept at altitudes of more than 1,000 kilometers, it has been very specifically designed to have an interception below 300 kilometers to ensure the safety of the space assets which are there, and also to see that the debris decay very fast. And it is also chosen in such a way that the ISS space station is at least about 120, 125 kilometers above. And it was also a head-on collision which has been planned to ensure that the debris won't fly high. And lots of simulations have been done to see that debris aspect is not a concern at all in various aspects. That's how the mission planning has been done.